Kann ich das nur keine Zusammenkunft? Keine.
Think only about basketball from the other day till what plays is, because all these players they served, they are good players and they are not fighters. The other day was not good for anybody. They apologized too, so it's enough. Let's talk about basketball.
Thank you.
Thank you. Bless you.
Alexander Liu, MS for Bulgaria. Coach, first of all, congrats on the win. I have two questions more related to defense and one to the offense. First of all, defensively, do you think that such a simple approach in the 2-3 zone will be effective again in game number 4, as it was today? That means that, do you think that the 3-point shooting of Partizan is the biggest downside of the team? And second of all, offensively, you trusted Nigel Williams-Goss today with some big shots. You have Rudy Fernandez, Sergio, you players who have many big games in their careers. Why did you decide to put the ball in Nigel Williams-Goss' hands?
First of all, about the zone defense and about the success on the 3-point shots of Partizan. I think that the zone sometimes even can work against good shooters. If you play good defense. And Partizan was scoring from the spot up too many times, but they create a lot of penetrations, and they are killing us with this kind of penetrations, and we need to take care of this. Today, the more defense works, but as I told before, not always works. I don't know what will happen in the next game. We will try the same, or we will try different. This is a playoff, and there's a back-to-back, and we have to be ready to anything happen in the next one for our opponents, and probably we are taking care of this. But let's see how it will be the plan. And about Nigel Williams, is playing amazing this season. He got some injuries, and we never used to talk about the players individually. We tried to talk about the team, and today all the other players play great too. Mario Hesonia, Sergi Jul, Zana Musa, Aram Hanga, Chacho Rodriguez, all of them played good because we won the game. One player can win nothing. And today we play as a team and we work together in bad moments, and this was more important than even the last shot.
Thank you. More questions? If that's it, we'll. Oh, sorry,
Kunazimovic. Good evening, coach. Congrats on the win. I have a question that's related to the things that happened in the game, too. There were some reports that Real Madrid, as a club, will make some sanctions upon Yabusele, especially, but we didn't see that happen. Is that something that's going to happen, or
this is not much a question for me. I think this is a question for not everyone who will have an eye. I try to manage my players, I try to coach my players, and that's it. I talk about it, I said, finish. Let's talk about basketball and finish. And my agreement is the last time I have talked about it, because I want to talk about basketball.
Okay. Thanks.
Thank you. Sorry, one
question.
Sorry.
Yeah.
Good evening, Nicholas Berkovich, Master Sport. Congratulations on the victory. You said that Poirier got injured before the start of the match.
Yes.
Is he going to be available on Thursday night?
I don't know, because when we were warming up, this happened. He was outside the team tonight, three weeks, and he couldn't practice nothing, just playing. And probably this happened because he made a very big effort in the last two games we played, because we played against Partizan, and after that, now we play against Zaragoza. And these two big efforts probably made without practicing. This is something that is not healthy for players, and sometimes this can happen. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
And continue with Coach Rosovic. Thank you.
Thank you.
Настина, без конференция за медии, време, че това стои, но една моя информация сутра, че те са тъй другите продаят дени хубавица за Утренец обра 4. Продаят се отвия изключило на Благиене стадиона и на родини местима доле много мило Знайковича, значи сутра от 10 по-интро. Няма да им континуваме да пръскам, тъй се издържа това беше точно. Пак за моята следа изгледа се. Коч, какво ти е паметно?
Vidi, prvo često Real Madrid from the victory, stand to the side again. We start very good. The more important thing is that we didn't move the ball more offensively and because of our bad offense was again. Everything else more or less it was, let's say, normal game against an assist great team, but it's good. We have one more game over here in our court and from the hard people, and of course, I want to thank them to one more incredible night for you.
Thank you. Questions in English, in Norwegian?
Yeah.
Just wait for a microphone, please.
Lucas Cortez, VarsityNews.com. Good evening, Coach. Good. What was your plan against Eddie Tavares? What went right, what went wrong, and how the presence of Matias Vassot is going to change after the game?
My plan it was against Real Madrid, not against Tavares. Because there were there another 11 players. So they play basketball 5 against 5, not 1-1. So of course I think your plan it was same like we prepared the rest of the games. Of course it is important that you don't have another big guy and you know everybody how Matias is important for us. But I believe that this report was so important. I said that our problem is offensive. That we didn't shoot the ball good, we didn't take good shots, and because of this, we lost it.
Sure.
Yes, please.
After game two, you asked the fans, the Partizan fans, stop looking to behave correctly in game three. And as we all saw, it was a perfectly fine and fiery and very good atmosphere. What can you say about the fan base and
very proud of all people. Very proud that one more time picture outside of Belgrade all over Europe because everybody expects this game. And some people start to, you know, to make the comments before they start the game that over here we held that we did many bad things. Finally, nothing happened. We play basketball and I'm very proud of them. And I, of course, I will please them to continue that way because it's important to play good basketball, important to win the game, but more important is still hospitality to understand everybody. How is your people in Serbia? You're very proud of this.
Thank you. Let's get a microphone.
Coach Alexander Lilo, Massport Team Bulgaria. First of all, I have a few questions. First of all, do you regret not putting in Justin Vukcevic earlier? Because we saw him in the second half, he was maybe the only big body beside Alex Milovic who could have controlled some passes, who could have deflected some passes to Walter Tavares. And second of all, how did you see the last possession? We saw a lot of contact. Do you think that there was a foul that was not called?
I live with my players 24 hours there. So I know very well who is able to help in any moment. So all decision going on that way. Last position, it was some kind of contact. First of all, Dante, foul, reference decided from Kobo to Utah. I never comment this situation.
If we don't have more questions in English, we'll proceed to questions in Serbian. Something in English? Serbian, okay. Rada Nikolic, how you have a problem?
Dobro večer, želim Rada Nikolic, sport klub. Kakva je situacija? Vidim da ste koristili Dante Ekuma, s obzirom na ovu njegovu povredu i kakva je situacija sa Aleksom
Obradovićem? Da. Pa i tu su se pravili neke vrste, da li kažem, razlogazne interpretacije što se tiče Dante povrede. Ne dečko želeo da pomogne, ja ću zamolim od našeg doktora Momu Nikolića da objavi sliku kako izgleda njegov prst u Marinu. Na nosi. Ja ću to da zaista ne zamolim da uradim, pošto to je bilo katastrofa. Oni su uspeli da naprave nevjerojatan posao ovih par dana, a i njegova želja ogromna je bila da pomogne timu. I I on sigurno nije 100% spreman za te bore. Ali ovi su ti terapeuti i doktori su radili, ja čestitam na tome i zahvaljujem se naravno Dante u koji je želeo i pomogao timu svojeg koliko je mogao. Što se tiče Aleksa, on se žalio na pogled na te ruke, već ja znam zaista on kako je stavio. Zaista.
Hvala. Gospodine Bradić, Trpić Bilance. Gospodine Bradić, samo jedan kratak komentar vezano za ovu statistiku koja kaže da u prvoj četvrtini je sve izgledalo da ide neku utakmicu koja možda ne bi bila na jednu loptu, a u drugoj četvrtini isti tim manje više dolazi u neku situaciju da se stigne ta razlika, odnosno da na kraju iz ove druge četvrtine tog rezultata uđemo u ovaj
završen. Nisam imali dobro ovdje kratno otvorene, imali smo ispitane šuteve i mi smo radili ono što zgrasi pod tim da imamo ekstra pas. Bio bi presrećen, to sam rekao, mislim možda onda vaše klupe, ako se ne sećam, ako neko može vrati film, tri šuta otvorene. Jedan je bio Trifunović, prvi, drugi je bio Vramović, treći je bio Anjušić. I rekao sam po vremenu, ako nastavimo da imamo tako otvorene šute, nema ih problema. Međutim, pre toga su bili ispitani šutevi i pre toga mi smo radili taj pas više na kojem ja stalno insistiram i koji da skrasi protiv. Tako da razlog tog druge četvrtine je bio to i razlog smo imali prilično usporeno u drugom poluvremenu generalno bio taj to sam pričao.
Ljubav Mišković, Partizan Beograd. Dobro večer, pre svega, čest i Lindu, dosta dobro i kvalitetne partije.
Hvala.
Teo bih jedno čisto ovako logično pitanje. Koliko je teško dobiti Real Madrid četvrti put bi ovo bilo za mjesec dana? To su ogromne igrači, ogromna tela, izuzetan kvalitet. Rekli si sami 11-12 bivših iz NBA igrača, razumijem?
Znam, dobro mislim. Ja sam rekao da sam ponosan na sve ovo što moji igrači radili. U zadnjih praktično mjesec dana četvrti put smo bili protiv Reala. Prilično smo onako dobro igrali ovdje dobro, dobro tako se odrigu, čak i večeras, u svim ovim datim okolnostima. Ja sam to pred utakmicu najavio i dao informaciju, možda ljudi ne znaju da ima 11 igrača koji su igrali na NBA-u, da je njihov roster, znači da mogu da dozvole sebi luksu da biraju koji će im igra, naravno igrač koji je tu najdominantni sigurno Tavares. Međutim, nemam ja razlog da ne nastavim da verujem u svoje igrače, da znam da će imati vetar leđa ponovo naših fenomenalnih navijača i što nam izgleda pitao, ponovo pošli na širu sliku u Evropi ili večeras to bilo zaista fenomenalno. Znači sve ono što se pričalo, što se potencijalo, da je ovdje čeka pakava, da će ovdje bude ne znam kakva atmosfera, naše navijači su podali fenomenalno i to je verovatno najvažnija stvar od svega. Daj Bože, volio bih naravno da se plasiramo na Final Four, ali također volio da se nastavi ta slika iz Evropa. I mislim da je to pravi put u kome treba svi da razmišljamo i da idemo na taj način.
Hvala. Hvala. Uklino Štetović, sve iznenu. Koliko vas ohrabruje to što ste bez dva vrlo bitna igrača i probili u prilici da pobedite ovakav Real?
Rekao sam da najveći problem naša čas je bio taj, znači na tome ćemo sigurno radimo sutra. Da pogledamo video uvek nešto što pomaže igračima, da shvate da vide poziciju i da nastavimo da igramo na način kako smo ono primirali u prvoj štini. To je ono što je evidentno. Bilo je nekih trenutaka i odbrane gdje je realno posti za vrema lajke po jednom tranziciji kad niste imali faul. I to je također deo igre koji je veoma važan. Ja uvijek pričam o tome da je faul veliko oružje na način. Treba koristiti na pametan način. I ako to budemo popravili, ja bih imao velike šanse da prođemo i da se hvala kako na najfor.
Hvala.
Srđan,
izvolite. Dobro večer, gospodine Pravić, Srđan Čedorov iz Telegram Sport. Pa ti su da ne dališemo posljed na 20 sekundi pred kraj, kada je Nigel Williams gost dao tu, da kažemo, i odlučujuću trojku. Da li ste možda imali neki drugačiji plan da manite taj posljed ili je ispalo kako je bilo planirano?
Nemo šta, mi smo igrali odbranu i rekli smo igrali odbranu koji smo prethodno odigrali, ovo je čista situacija 1-1. Znači, ja čovjek vidi loptu, obrve ste bek, nego se ubacio. To Ta kvalitet koji on ima kao igrač, da je promašio, vjerojatno bi ga svi iz Reala pitali za neke stvari, što je tako, ali to je kvalitet koji ima taj igrač. Veliki koš koji je učitak.
Pa, izvolite.
Vraćam gospodinu Obradoviću, još je većni dan pravni front. Ja Mandara za sada ima odličnu seriju, šarginalnu. I u odbrani, i u napadu, a i u ovoj utakmici nakon odlične četvrtine, malo je ispao iz ritma. Koliko je bilo do toga da je Real Madrid dao do napadu, mislim, uopšte u kojem s faulovima. Koliko je to uticalo na ishod utakmice?
No, ja imam odličnu i glavu stigra celu seriju, znači. Ona utakmica prva koju smo dobili, njegova odbrana je bila za sebe. Tako da ja sam to rekao pred svim igračima i to je izazvalo da je u drugoj utakmici neki drugi igrači odigraju na sličan način odbranu kako odigraju Madrid. Jer Čedas je bio izuzetno važan igrač za nas, ušao je rano, to je stalo na tribine, to je ono što nije više na parketu. Znači ovo je Ukrajina i njega koji su ostali igrači. Vjerovatno mi treba se zapitamo, gdje se trenutno nalazi? Kada je česta utakmica. 2-0 vodimo, dobili smo dva puta Real Madrid u Madridu. Igramo ovdje gore. Šta drugo da kažem sebi da verujem našem uzi? I da ja nastavim da imam povjerenje da predvidim ovdje. To je to, naravno. Utakmica je takva, ja pokušam sve da radim, da mogu ti znam što bolje. Prave se greške, ali to je sastavni deo posla, tako da još jedno pomene, probat ćemo da utičemo na to, da odigramo najbolju moguću utakmicu za 6-8 sati.
Da li imate še kako? Ukoliko to sve informaciju o treningu sutra, da ću vam poslati nakon.
Trening sutra te. Ale, 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 ale